something. Hoping to find hope in this hopeless world we live in. What you give is what you given. Gotta make wise decisions. Gotta stay tunnel vision. Gotta avoid collision. Keep scratching the surface and keep your palms itching. Gotta pay moms a visit. It's been a while. I've been working, she keep telling me she miss her child. I find myself passing the house, then I spin around. She say I'm always moving, ma, I just can't sit around. Oh my, cause the cash ain't gonna come to us. When we was down, who gave a dime or gave a for us? So instead of making it hard, I made it fun for us. Make it easy, so when you need it, you just run it.
Hey everybody, it's the coach, and this is Madden 19 on ESPN.
Thank you, Coach. We are in the Pacific Northwest as we get set for football at CenturyLink Field here in Seattle. Today, it's an NFC West battle between the San Francisco 49ers and the Seattle Seahawks. Williams to return. And he'll take it up past the 25 to the 26-yard line. So here's the first drive now for the 49ers. They'll have Jimmy G calling the shots. Grew up in the northern suburbs of Chicago, went to Eastern Illinois. Jimmy Garoppolo.
And what I loved about meeting with him before the game was talking to a guy who takes ownership of his performance. Two touchdowns, two interceptions last week, but all he focused on was the loss, okay? And he did say, if I change my stats a little bit, not necessarily for me to look better, but that'll help the team.
Wide open, it's Allen, complete. And they work this well upfield across the 45. A quick check on the numbers for Keenan Allen from last week. Three catches, 132 yards, and a touchdown.
And he's trying to prove the adage, it's not just how you start, it's how you finish. And he is finishing awfully strong, takes great care of his body. I expect him to go ahead and put a capper on this season.
On first down, Garoppolo. That's to the right side, complete to Kittle. And he'll be brought down at the 48-yard line. A gain of six there on first.
How about the timing on that one, where they were in sync, weren't they? Three-step drop, balls out of his hands, right to the tight end. Nice completion, just like they do it in practice.
6 yards was the pickup on the last completion, so here's second and four. The former second-round pick, this is Joe Mixon. And he's going to fight his way forward here for a modest gain. And give him about four on the play, but he's marked short, so it'll be third and about the length of the football. Pretty good job defensively. Thought he was going to get it, but they knew where that marker was, and they stopped him just short of it.
What it does is emphasize that strategic football and situational football is not just played on the offensive side, is it? Defense understanding, as you noted, where the first down marker was and making sure they didn't get there.
They give to Mixon to try to pick it up. And he's got the first down yardage before he's brought down at the 42. They only get two there, but on third and one, that's all they needed to keep the drive going. Defense had a chance to get off the field here on the opening drive, couldn't do it.
I know that we go into these meetings with coaches, and sometimes maybe we can get, you know, a little bit numb because they're always going to talk about how important third down is, aren't they? Offense and defense. In this case, one capitalized, and the other, as you said, had a chance to get off the field and didn't get it done.
And he stopped immediately there. No gain on the play there. Second down. Off the corner, where'd he come from? Well, I guess he came off the corner, but really nice play.
I like when you're able to pose a question and answer it at the same time. That's exactly where he came from, but it's not something that you normally see. Most of the time, we're thinking about those guys covering pass catchers. In this case, he was a big factor in a run game, no gain.
And this is incomplete.
What's the old adage, be quick but don't hurry? Well, that went right out the window there. He was hurried, harassed. That ball had to be gotten rid of, otherwise he was going to get sacked.
They come up to the line now facing a third and 10 after the incompletion. From the gun, it's Garoppolo. And the Seahawks defense gets to him and they bring him down.
Well, how about that? A dime set on defense, six defensive backs. None of them blitz. They're just back there in coverage. defensive lineman gets the sack.
That's where the O-line, they go to the sideline, they keep their helmets on so the cameras can't find them, right?
Yeah, the cameras can't find them, but I know one thing, the O-line coach will.
Wilson and the Seahawks take over now, first and 10 at their own 16. Here's Martin as they begin on the ground. And he'll take this up only to about his 18-yard line. 2 yards on the carry there. It'll be second down.
They tried a quick hitter inside, but that one was swallowed up because what they're hoping, this big defensive lineman will take the bait and move laterally and open up a crease that they can run through. Didn't happen on that play.
Now Wilson on second down. And the first pickup of his all-pro tight end, Rob Gronkowski. A good pickup there of 20 yards.
I do believe we'll see a little bit more of this as this game progresses, because when you can have that type of a game in the middle of the defense, it hurts them in so many ways, because most teams like to be strong down the middle. And if you can sting them there, that opens things up for them on the outside as well.
That's where he, their big tight end, is so good, that middle third, the seam routes, the in routes. Yeah, you're right. Probably see more of that.
Yeah, it takes a lot of courage and fortitude to go in the middle as well, and he's got it. Well, from their point of view, this game could not be starting out much better, could it? Force a punt on defense, and now they're moving it crisply on offense.
Crisply, I like that. Like yeah, that? Yeah, moving it very, very well. It looks like the defense on their heels a little bit. You put a score in here, long way to go, but you're right, that's a heck of a start.
Yeah, and I think this is where the play caller is looking at his play sheet and saying, to have that dagger play, to have that play and just finish them off right now, because I think they'd love to gain that big advantage early.
So second down and 10. Once again, they'll go from the 40. Second and 10. It's Wilson again. And seeing nowhere to throw, he chucks this one away from harm. Incomplete. Now it's third down. This offense was on the move. Now two straight incompletions have them looking at third and 10. Wilson. Got his man complete over the middle. That's Edwards. And he's going to get this inside the 30. 60 catches for him now on the year. This last one, a first down. That's what we're used to seeing from him right there. Plays like that, why he's number 4 in the league in terms of receiving yardage.
Able to make adjustments all along the way. Doesn't matter where he lines up, where he releases from. Working his way into the secondary, figures out defenses and finds weak spots in order to get open.
And they'll bring him down at the 18-yard line. That one good for 10 yards. And it'll be second and very short.
Park, I remember a coaching friend of mine used to tell his running backs before games, make sure you run and jog with your offensive line in pregame. Get used to the ground shaking when those big behemoths start to create space for you up front. He did a pretty good job of just following those guys through there for a nice explosive run.
Back to the ground. This time it's Martin. The numbers on the ground for Martin a week ago. 18 carries, 85 yards, and a touchdown.
They've got a nice scheme going right now, and they run the football pretty well. In fact, I was talking with him on the field before the game, and he said he's starting to hear from the guys ahead of him on the rushing yardage total, and they want to know if he's going to jump up there and join them at the top of the list.
He'll get it up the middle. No gain on the play that time, and it sets up second and goal.
Early down stuff to put this offense in a precarious position. We know that securing the point of attack, especially against the big-bodied guys in the middle of this D, has got to be priority one.
They'll give it to him up the middle, and that'll get him halfway there as he takes it from the 6 to the 3-yard line. Two straight shots on the ground. Now on third, do you go to the air?
I think the possibility exists, and if you're doing it, you're probably going play action since you ran it twice. But I often think that second down is the time you go play action and throw the ball. I say commit to the run and think about it being 4 down territory.
They'll run for it with Martin. And they'll get him down just shy of the goal line at about the 1. He needed three. He got two. Now that'll set up an interesting situation here on fourth and a yard.
There are certain drives in the game where anything less than a touchdown that caps it feels like an absolute disappointment. This is one of those drives.
They'll run for it. Martin. And I don't think he got in. He didn't. He's stoned at the one-yard line. Martin stops short of the goal line. And his 49er defense stands tall down near the goal line. The fourth down run successful. Now they look to pay it off on first down. Here's Joe Mixon as they start on the ground. And he will forge his way forward only up to the two-yard line. In on the stop, it was the UCF product, Shaquem Griffin.
I know the scouting report on him is that he doesn't possess the eye discipline to be an elite linebacker. And what that means is his ability to read, react, and make a play. But on that one, he looked like one of those guys.
Now Joe Mixon. And he'll get this only up to about the three-yard line. He'll pick up only a yard there, and it'll leave him with a third and seven.
Well, that didn't appear to be a run blitz. He just darted in once he saw the run develop. That appeared to be a case of see ball, get ball.
Facing the prospect of a punt from their own end zone, they need some cushion. Let's see what they can do on third down. A handoff to Mixon, and he's going to be taken down shy of the five-yard line. Just a one-yard gain on the play, and that'll mean a call to the punt team as it's fourth down. We haven't seen much from him running the football here in this first quarter.
No, you're right about that. We haven't seen much of him at all so far. They've stacked him up pretty well, but when you're trying to run the football, sometimes you've got to play the long game. Keep handing it to him, and some of those runs that aren't working now, they turn into six, seven, eight, and maybe more.
Wilson and the Seahawks take over now, first and 10 at their 36-yard line. Going to be met at the line of scrimmage and taken down. No gain on the play. It'll be second down. Well, if you look where that play starts, O-line versus D-line, that was a battle won by the D-line.
Yeah, and oftentimes it's won by quickness off the ball. Who can handle the guy across from them best? On that play, the defensive line did exactly that.
And now Wilson unhappy with something he saw there as he's going to burn a timeout. He'll have two remaining as we step aside here in this second quarter. Second down, Martin, and that one blown up quickly as he's going to be stopped before he could even get started. It'll go as a loss of a yard, and it'll set up third down.
Some of these play calls, I think they're a little conservative, but you know me, because it's easy to sit up in this booth, right, and make all the calls and think I'm going to be correct. But I would like to see them open things up, because otherwise this defense is going to gang up on the run and set them down.
On third down, Wilson. And he fires one that's intercepted. Picked off right around the 43. And he's going to be taken down here with a penalty flag on the field.
Holding defense.
Wait a second. They did not accept that after the incompletion. What? Your look is just as puzzled as mine.
I got nothing for you here. You have to take that penalty, don't you?
It's 3 yards. And he hauls it in the end zone. Touchdown, San Francisco. T.Y. Hilton hitting double digits with his 10th touchdown of the season. And the Niners are able to cash in for six. Well, that didn't take long. The turnover instantly almost turning into points.
And when that happens, a lot of teams have the mentality of let's strike right now. You've got them off balance after the turnover or the takeaway. Let's go get it. And that's exactly what they did.
And they'll take it past the 25 and up to the 28-yard line. Here's Russell Wilson and the Seahawk offense now getting set to go again. He's got to dig deep here, doesn't he? Team's losing. He's not playing well either.
And they always tell you, don't press. You'll make things a little bit worse. But in this particular situation, you try and heighten your play a little bit. So far, he's thrown one interception. He wants to balance that off with at least one touchdown pass in order to get his team back moving forward. When defenses get to the quarterback that quickly, a lot of times it's called a jailbreak. It wasn't quite that fast, but fast enough that he had no time to look downfield and set himself to throw the ball. And as he tried to do that, he was hit and it forced an incompletion.
Another throw on second down, and this one incomplete as well. And that one goes incomplete. He's maybe lucky it wasn't a fumble as he got hit as he threw it.
One of the great coaches said football is really a simple game. Rush theirs, protect yours. And he's talking about those guys throwing the football. In this situation, the rush won, hitting the quarterback and forcing him into an incompletion.
He's got Lockett. And he'll be taken down, but not before they work it across midfield. That one goes for 24 yards.
We always hear about the connections some quarterbacks have with certain receivers. I think this guy has a connection with just about everyone. Didn't mind throwing it in there against double coverage to him.
Wilson hit. It's loose. It's out. Fumble. But I believe a Seahawk was able to get a handle on this, so this will remain Seattle ball.
On plays like this where the ball comes free, it's often unusual for the team that lost it to get it back because this is a quarterback. The ball gets away from him. Everyone else is trying to execute what they're supposed to do on offense. They're usually looking in the other direction, downfield, or have moved away from him. In this case, though, a teammate is able to come up with the ball.
And off comes to Martin. And he'll be brought down, it looks like, right at the 40. It's a pickup of 19 yards on the play. And they're going to face a third down.
Look, the first down marker is out there, but sometimes it's hard to find for an offense when they're in a long yardage situation, which usually means throw the football. In this case, they went against the tendency and ran it, and boy, the reward was there. A big, big pickup, and guess what? It's now third and very short in order to try and pick up a first down.
They'll run it. Here's Martin, and he's going to have the first down yardage to the 35. They get five out of that one, and it moves the chains.
We all love to have a home run hitter in the backfield. Guys can take it the distance. But a short yardage, trying to pick up first downs, that big guy, always a nice luxury to have, isn't he?
This offense finding its legs now. Here's another first and 10. Penny, a first down carry. 2 yards on the pickup there. It'll be second and 8.
Well, he's looking for some running room, and there wasn't a whole lot of it there on that play. I think he was lucky to get a couple yards out of it because those defenders, they were rallying to the football pretty quickly.
They give to Martin. And able to push his way forward here for a good little gain. 6 yards on the pickup, and that's going to lead to a third down.
I thought that was a good call. Passing situation on second down, they hit him with a draw instead and pick up nice yardage.
Yeah, because the draw, they're thinking pass when they see that initially defensively, right?
But you know, in today's NFL, most of the time on second and long when it's a passing situation, pass rushers are out in the field, and they're only thinking one thing, get to the quarterback. And oftentimes you can bypass him with a running play.
It goes as a gain of 8, it moves the chains.
Yeah, once more, strong running, excellent blocking at the point of attack. They've got a nice little drive brewing right here.
A handoff to Penny, and nothing doing. He's immediately taken down at the line of scrimmage. Travis Carey there to make the tackle. Well, usually you don't think of the cornerback coming in for a no-gain play, but that's what we had there. Nice tackle.
Yeah, and how about the range, too? Coming from the outside part of the play, moving his way into the inside and making that play happen. No gain for the offense, big play for the defense.
There goes Martin, first down and more. And he'll be out of bounds. 18 yards there, and it'll be a first and goal.
On any explosive run, you can almost feel the ground shaking, and that's from the offensive linemen creating space for their runners. I had an old coach tell me before, they always told his runners, run around the offensive line in pregame. Get used to the ground shaking so you don't trip and fall when it happens in a game.
They'll run, Martin, and he's across the chalk into the end zone. Touchdown, Seahawks. A great effort there. His 17th touchdown now on the season. And the Seahawks just an extra point away from tying this thing up. And he was excellent on that drive. He deserved to be the one to get across the chalk.
Oh, I agree with you totally. A workhorse on the drive. And how about that last decisive run to punch it in?
Time for our first check of the NFL scoreboard. And it's the Browns out to the early advantage. I have a feeling that one's going to stay tight throughout. We'll continue to monitor.
Free kick out of bounds. Kicking team.
And that drives coaches insane, doesn't it? When they see that happen, it just doesn't feel right, does it? Plus, you're giving up yardage.
Garoppolo going to bring the Niners up here first and 10 at the 40. Here's a give to Mixon. And he takes it past the 45 and down at the 46. It's a six-yard pickup, and it gets him to second and 4.
They'd love to just strike back with a touchdown right here. And if it's a long play, so be it. But the main goal, get a couple of first downs, run some plays, run some clock, allow their defense to get a chance to catch their breath, settle down, and relax a little bit after they just gave up the score.
And he'll be brought down at the 48-yard line. They get 6 on the pickup there as the drive will continue.
So many teams want to throw the ball in this situation nowadays, but I love watching a team that has enough confidence to go ahead and run the football in that situation. That's almost a tendency breaker.
Mixon with a first down carry. And that play will go nowhere. Losing yardage back near midfield at the 49. On second down, here's Mixon. And he'll get this into enemy territory, but not by much, as he's down to the 48. 2 yards gets him back to where they started, but now third and 10.
I do know from experience that when you slow down someone's running game, you're now doing the dictating on defense. And guess what? Now you're getting ready to tee off on their quarterback because they have to throw it all the time. But you still have to be alert for the draws and other plays of that nature to make sure you don't get hurt.
Now Garoppolo. And he's got his man. It's Darbo. And he'll be brought down with the first down and a late flag here, too. And he may get a few more tacked on for good measure.
Defense.
Well, we looked at each other right away. We knew that flag was coming out.
And I always enjoy the conversation post because officials always tell you, I don't want to throw the flag. But you caused the play. You did it. I had to.
After the penalty, a fresh set of downs. It's first and 10. 2 minutes to play in a tightly contested first half. And we remind you, coming up at the half, we'll join who, Charles?
The coach.
The coach, Jonathan Coachman, standing by in Orlando. He'll have stats and scores from games in progress, as well as scores from earlier today.
The coach.
Yeah, we get slap happy up here sometimes. And he'll be brought down this time at the 5-yard line. That'll bring up second and goal after the gain of 5.
I know many people like to throw to the tight end, maybe in a little flexed out position because he creates mismatches with his size. The slot receivers do the same thing with their quickness, their speed, and their route running savvy.
Garoppolo to throw on second down. A hit as he throws there, incomplete.
But one thing that I've liked defensively is that they've shown him a lot of different looks here in the first half. They've come after him. They've sat back. I think that's what you need to do to keep an offense guessing.
And they certainly have kept him on their toes. That's why they haven't had much success on the scoreboard. This stadium once registered as the loudest roar ever recorded, and you can hear him now. Third and goal. Looking to throw, Garoppolo. And it's complete in the end zone. Touchdown, 49ers. Jimmy Garoppolo with his second touchdown pass of this first half. And the Niners are able to cash in for 6. He's having a nice little first half here, partner.
And it's a first half that leaves us anticipating what can still come. I mean, 2 touchdowns already here through the second quarter. There could be plenty more before this game is over.
Now it's Lucky Whitehead on the return. Oh, able to avoid him. And that should give his guys a spark. He's up all the way to the 44-yard line.
And that's the kind of return you're looking for. To get to that spot on the field, that allows you to do a lot of things on offense.
Getting set to go again as we look at the back heading onto the field again. And the ground game's been good, but they're losing here in the second quarter. Can they use that ground game maybe to work the air attack a little bit more?
I think so, because now you can throw play action off of being able to run the ball effectively. And oftentimes you might want to swing your back out of the backfield, get the ball in his hands in open space. And just don't get totally away from running it, because some of these runs now, they may pop bigger as the game goes along.
Yeah, they've been good with a run so far. Another tote for the workhorse, Martin. Only three there on the pickup, but that's enough to move the chains. First down now, but that clock rolling. On first down, Wilson. Flushed out right. Over the middle, complete. That's Edwards. And he'll go down here at the 35-yard line. Give him nine there on the first down completion. Now Martin. 2 yards on the pickup there, but it's enough to give him a new set of downs. And now before this first down play, we're going to get a timeout here. As they stop it here with just under 40 ticks to go in this first half. So they'll come up first and 10 now from the 33. They'll throw on first down with Wilson. And he was hit as he threw it there, and it forces it incomplete.
This defense has been very disruptive early on as they force another one to go awry.
Seems to be the front and the back end. Pass rush, they've been able to get home, and they're taking the ball away in coverage as well.
I love how you put it together. The front and back working in sync, only way to play good defense.
Wide open receiver complete. Now hold everything here. We're going to get a timeout by the offense as they stop it with 28 seconds to go in the first half of play. Zone now. Here's Wilson on first down. Eluding the pressure right. And that one's going to be over everybody in the back of the end zone. It's incomplete.
Boy, you will not see a quarterback of his caliber miss on one like that very often. I mean, there it is, wide open, got the shot, and he misfires.
We talk about, boy, he'll want that one back all the time. He definitely wants that one back. And he's got it. Zone for the Seahawk touchdown. Rob Gronkowski as the first half is winding down. And the Seahawks just an extra point away from tying this thing up. Prater for the extra point.
After nearly 30 minutes of football, that touchdown puts us in a position where if they make the extra point, we're right back to even before we start the second half.
Get a chance to return this one as it's through the end zone for a touchback. The clock showing just 16 seconds till the half as they line up first and 10. They'll start here with a give to Mixon, and he'll fight forward to about the 27-yard line. Give him a couple on the carry there, second and 8. They'll break the huddle, come up on second and 8 at the 27-yard line. So thanks to the late, we now proceed to the start of the second half. And ready to get the party started for the second half. It was an even first half, all tied on the scoreboard. This is taken about 7 yards deep. And it's a pretty good return here as he'll get it up to the 29-yard line. The Seattle offense now set to come back out on the field. First half showed us some pretty good offense. Tie game, we'll see what the second half brings.
And it'll be interesting because I think both sides feel pretty good about what their offenses are doing. Gotta wonder what adjustments are being made defensively to try and get a spark and maybe slow down the other side.
But here, do you change up anything on this opening drive?
Not offensively, you don't. You got everything going your way. You're probably prepared for maybe some change-ups you might expect. But overall, you like what your game plan's showing you.
This home crowd, they're happy with that call.
I like the way you said happy there, right? The so-called good guys didn't get a call. They feel like it's been that way all afternoon. You feeling their pain?
They finally got one.
Yes, they did.
Following the penalty, Martin got some real estate inside the 30. And he takes it all the way down to the 22. That's good for 21 yards and a first down.
Boy, where would these guys be without his performance on the ground? That puts him over 100 yards now for the afternoon, and I tell you, he seems to be getting stronger as the day goes along.
They keep it on the ground. This time it's Penny, and he's got four down inside the 20 to the 18.
When you find that kind of yardage, you couldn't be more confident as a ball carrier. And guess what? You're going to go back and tell your offensive coordinator, I'd like to keep carrying it, thank you.
And they'll run it again with Penny, and they'll get him down right around the 16. It'll be a pickup of a couple, and it leaves them with a third and three.
Well, they had that one sniffed out. Excellent run blitz. Stopped that one for a short gain.
What makes a good run blitz a good run blitz?
The ability to stay on task, to follow up your assignment, go to the gap you're supposed to cover, and not be deterred by anything else.
And he will have the first down before he's tackled at the 12. A gain of four that time as the drive continues.
Someone's been having a good game so far, and you know something? A lot has been power running. They decided to turn him loose again on third down, didn't they?
They did indeed. He delivered the tough yards. Carry number 20 here for Martin. And he's going to fight his way forward here for a modest gain. He'll get a nice chunk there on the first down run, and it's second and four.
This drive is pretty clear. Almost feels like old school fundamentals, doesn't it? Want to impose their will on the defense? What's that, five straight runs?
Yeah, five straight carries to start this drive. And like you said, the way it's working, they may just stick with it. They run, Martin. And he will not be denied. Into the end zone, touchdown Seahawks. A great play there. His second touchdown of the afternoon. And the Seahawks are going to take the lead. He's giving him a little jolt. Just gave him the lead there. But two TDs now in the game.
And that jolt puts them in the lead. What a terrific job by him. He is carrying the ball and simply saying, I want to win.
And now he's hoping his defense has that mentality as they try to hang on to that lead. And a good return as he'll be stopped just shy of the 30-yard line. Here's a look at the 49ers offense as they make their way out for their first possession of the second half. They're down in this game. A chance for the offense, though, to put something on the board, get some momentum here at half two.
Try and get things kick-started for them. And you know what to have.
Mixon hit, and all the ball is out. And the Seahawks have recovered. Not the trend he wanted to start the season with, a fumble lost in both weeks one and two. Now, it's not a disaster, but certainly not what he was looking for.
Got to get that fixed because otherwise he shows up on every scouting report. I remember sitting in defensive rooms and hearing the scouting report from my coaches, and if someone had a particular problem carrying the ball and holding on to it.
After review of the play, the ruling on the field is reversed.
Recovery. It's Garoppolo toward the left sideline, but it's incomplete. Keenan Allen, the intended target, and it's third down.
Had the right idea there, trying to throw it to the sideline, but he led him just a little bit too much, trying to get it out to his receiver. Ends up falling to the ground, incomplete.
The Niners on third down. They've converted three out of five thus far. This will be third and five. Working from the gun, Garoppolo. And that will be incomplete as well.
I'm not sure we could spot any tendency here on this third down. They could have run it or passed it. Either one was available. They chose to try and get it through the air, but they were unsuccessful.
Now this is fielded in the end zone. Oh, leaves him behind on the spin. A good return there, 17 yards. And it'll be Seahawk football as they take over deep in their own territory. Russell Wilson now gears up to lead the offense again. The lead is theirs here in the third quarter, but It's really been the ground game that's been the recipe for success.
You mean the spotlight isn't shining as brightly on the guy throwing it?
No, it's the man behind him that's had a heck of a game.
And that's really okay. That's actually what you're looking for. I mean, your pride tells you, hey, I want to be responsible, I want to throw a bunch of touchdown passes. But when you're able to run the football, typically speaking, your team's doing pretty well. And in this case, they're winning.
We'll see if they have balance on this drive. On second down, here's Penny. And this time not as successful as he'll get back to the line of scrimmage and no more. Call it no gain that time as it's going to leave him with a third and about three to go. The Seahawks on third down. They've been very good, 5 for 7 thus far. Here it's third and three. Now it's Martin. And an alley to run. And he's going to get this one across the 30-yard line. And a nice carry there of 15 yards.
They're trying to show that they can run the ball, protect this lead, give it to the backs, play a little bit of keep away, don't you think?
And that's probably a good philosophy at this point, going to make that defense stand up and stop them. So they'll come up first and 10 now from the 33. Here's a give to Penny, and the hole closes quickly. He gets it across the 35 to the 36-yard line. 3 yards on the pickup there, and it'll be second down.
Looks like they're establishing a pretty good pattern here because they've been very heavy in the running game on the last four plays.
Yeah, you took the words right out of my mouth. So far, four plays in this drive, all four on the ground. Now they'll throw it with Wilson. He's going to float this one deep right side, and he's unable to grab it. Thought he might have had position, couldn't hold on, third down.
But that certainly looked like something that they discussed all week in practice, getting ready for this one. Take the big shot right out of the gate. At worst, you'll open up the defense a little bit, loosen them up, have them back on their heels.
They head to the line facing a 3rd and 7 following the incompletion on second down. And he couldn't hang on to it through the contact. Incomplete.
The beauty of being able to play a zone defense when you can sit back and see the ball coming out of the quarterback's hands. Guess what? Creates a lot of confusion, kind of muddle in the middle of the field where you go make a play on the football.
The 49ers offense now, they get set to head back on the field. And a tight game after punting last time. See if they can get something going on this drive.
As they head to the field now, with the game this close, you've got to feel there's a sense of urgency for them going on offense right now. But they have to do it without letting panic creep in and affect their play.
And he'll find some space up to about the 25. A solid run on first down. Gain of 7 leaves him with a 2nd and 3.
Well, no matter how they phrase it, staying on schedule, staying ahead of the sticks, whatever you want to call it, 7 yards on first down, that fits the bill.
Second down, here's Garoppolo. On the right side, it's Hilton with a catch. And he'll get it up to the 33-yard line. He's been big, 2 touchdowns earlier. Now he's got a first down here. And he's certainly been a huge factor in this. When he's got the 2 touchdowns to his credit, now they look to him again. He picks up the first.
Yeah, I can hear everyone saying, well, why don't you cover him, double him, triple him, do what you have to do. But sometimes they get locked into such a groove and such a connection, it doesn't matter how many guys are in his area.
He certainly looks to be in that groove right now. And he'll be taken down, but not before they work it across midfield. And a nice gain of 21 yards.
When you're a player of his stature, you don't just circle the games on your team's calendar. You
circle the Pro Bowl?
Without a doubt. That's a game that you just figure you're going to be in each and every year. That's because of catches like that. That's why he goes.
This is Mixon. And he'll get this down only to about the 46. Credit him with a 1-yard gain there to make it 2nd and 9.
They tried a quick hitter inside, but that one was swallowed up because what they're hoping, those big defensive linemen will take the bait and move laterally and open up a crease that they can run through. Didn't happen on that play.
And he gets this inside the 35-yard line. 12 yards there as they move the chains.
I think they like this drive a little bit better there, partner. Running game helping out, picking up some of the slack. Because remember the last drive they went 3 and out.
Now Mixon. And he is met at the line of scrimmage and he goes down right there. Officially no gain on the play, and it's second down.
But it was stopped on that play. But he's had plenty of carries all afternoon. Every now and then the defense is going to win one, but I don't think they'll shy away from handing it to him the rest of the game.
Mixon. And he'll get a little over two, maybe a full three down to the 32-yard line.
Well, if the coaching staff's doing a good job upstairs, they'll file away what they just saw from the defense right there. They sold out to stop that running play. I'd say keep that in mind. They want to try that again, go play action, hit them over the top.
The Niners on third down. They've hit it 50%, 3 of 6 to this point. This is third and 8. Back now in Seattle, Washington. It's 49er football, but some ground to cover. They find themselves behind as we hit the fourth and final quarter. Throwing is Garoppolo on third down. He's going to walk one deep left side here. And that one incomplete. Had some position but couldn't hold on, and it brings up fourth down.
There's definitely contact there, but it's the fourth quarter of a kind of tight game, and sometimes the officials just say, let them play. Kind of like your mom used to, you and your brothers, just take the broom to you and send you out to the backyard and tell you to settle yourselves.
I like that, yeah. There was contact, I don't know, like you said, enough to warrant the flag. It was close, though. So an interesting call there to take the three. I mean, I guess they're thinking that their hands were tied, but, you know, fourth quarter, that field goal might not help them that much in the end.
Yeah, eventually they're going to need the touchdown. The thinking must have been they didn't feel confident about picking it up there, hoping maybe on defense they can get better field position, get a turnover, get a better play, and then they'll have a chance to attack the end zone.
Tennessee offense making their way out onto the field as you take a look at the playoff race in the AFC. And for the moment, they're sitting pretty in possession of that number 2 seed and, more importantly, perhaps that first-round bye.
But they have to clinch it, don't they?
Yeah.
That's the key, right? So, in a sense, the playoffs have started. They've got to go ahead and get this thing done. Otherwise, it's a different road, and you really don't want to be at the mercy of other teams and their results.
5 yards is the tally on first down. That brings up second and 5.
Well, Brandon Pace comes into play now because they've got the advantage. They've got the football, but they've got to be very careful about what speed they're going to play. You know, my music teacher back in New Paltz, Mrs. Bythema Bagley, used to say, don't go prestissimo when you really want to go largo. And what she meant by that is don't go too fast when you really want to go at a nice, slow, deliberate pace.
I am speechless. I am without speech. Now, meanwhile, a pass that should have been intercepted, but it winds up falling incomplete.
I think he's taking an awful chance with the football right there. You've got a lead, you've got to protect it, and he's taking chances putting it out there in a little bit of jeopardy.
Especially in a spot like this, fourth quarter, as you said, trying to cling to that advantage.
Yeah, that one probably should have been picked, huh?
Here's Wilson. Looking left side, and he's got a man. That's Edwards. And he'll be out of bounds after getting this one across the 40.
Holding offense.
So apparently some grabbing of the jersey there on the O-line.
Yeah, just working the interior, and that's where the penalty occurred.
Every penalty so critical at this stage of the game, as now they've got it third and long. Now it's Wilson. And incomplete. The contact made the ball roam free and brings up fourth down.
Anytime a defense can sit back in a zone like that, it tends to create a lot of congestion in the middle of the field. Makes it very hard to slot one in.
Looked like I-4 at rush hour in your hometown of Orlando, Florida. An absolute mess.
And did they keep it in? They did. They kept it in. It's down close to the goal line at the 1 yard line. And San Francisco gets set to go here. And we have seen a lot on the scoreboard here in this quarter. So sometimes you talk to me about tendency breakers on offense. These defenses struggling. Are there tendency breakers on defense?
All defensive coordinators keep something in their hip pocket. for these types of situations. What can we do to slow down the onslaught? But the biggest thing is make sure these guys encourage each other, pick themselves up, because right now, it's been a really tough ball game trying to stop these offenses.
Oh, it really has, especially as of late.
False start, offense.
The crowd's not doing that O-line any favors.
Home field advantage is really kicking in, making it very difficult for them to hear the snap count.
They were looking good on second down, but now they're backed up 5 yards by the false start, and it's second and eight. After the penalty, it's Mixon. They'll try to get forward, but he's going to be stopped in his tracks at about the three. Officially, no gain on the play, and they're left with a third and eight. The Niners on third down, 3 for 7 so far in this game. This is third and eight. Mixon. And this one will be taken up. They'll spot it right at the 7. It's a gain of 5, but it'll lead to a fourth down.
And there's a run to be happy with. Good, solid yardage. They'll take that any time you hand the ball to a back.
Returnable here from the 38. Well, he wasn't too far from breaking that. Officially, give him 15. And the Seahawks will have great field position to start this drive. They take over on the short side of the field. The Seattle now ready to march out of the field. They've got the lead. Last time had to punt it, though. What's the key to this drive?
I think it's leverage.
Leverage.
Big guys up front. You know the motivational speech on the sideline is, guys, give us an opportunity. Protect the passer. Create space for our runners, and let's go ahead and get these guys. Low man wins. Let's go do it on this drive.
We'll watch that lever. This is caught inside the 15. And they move this all the way down to the 9. They give them a gain of 38. So first and goal. 6 points here would go a long way toward wrapping this one up. Martin. And he maneuvers his way down to the 3-yard line. A good run of 6 yards there. Gets him closer to the goal line with second down coming up. Now, I'm guessing you'd say this is kind of the key here. Grind out some yardage. Work on that clock. See if you can continue to tick it down.
Definitely. You want to bleed things out at this point, right? Continue to possess the football. Gain some yardage and put the onus on the defense. You have to use timeouts. What are they going to do to stop you? You're taking charge.
And maybe a measure of revenge there. He's had his way in this one, but this time they get him behind the line.
Now, obviously, that's some good work there defensively, being able to stop them and bring up a key third down. But if you're on the offensive side of the ball, there's an opportunity, because I know what defensive guys are thinking right now, to stop them, get to the ball. That means it might not be sound defensively.
And he will take this one in for the Seattle touchdown. A great effort there. His third touchdown of the game, number 19 on the year. And the Seahawks find a way to stretch their lead. Extra point good by Prater. He keeps carrying the ball into the end zone, and in this one, he's sort of carrying the team on his back.
He's the reason that they lead right now, no question about it. And you talk about on his back, he's not minding the extra weight at all, is he? Carrying that just as lightly as he does the football. Yeah. What a great performance so far.
Those 3 touchdowns, it's got him in the lead. And San Francisco gets set to go here. These guys had to punt their last possession, and that's become too familiar of a refrain. Too many of these drives just wound up going nowhere.
But you know how in baseball, when the pitcher gets a base hit and he's on base?
He rifles one that's intercepted. Picked off by Levante David. And he brings it back to right around the 26-yard line.
Partner, we always talk about possessions being at a premium in these games, and now in this situation, throwing an interception here when you have to claw your way back in, that one's going to hurt, and in a big way.
Now Rashad Penny. So a nice job to break the one tackle, but not much daylight after that as he's brought down. DeForest Buckner in on the tackle. Got to figure now, after getting that turnover, they're just going to be happy to keep the ball on the ground, right?
This is where covering the football, taking care of the ball, all the ball security terms that have ever been used, they come into play for the guys on offense right now. Just take care of it, and they've got a good chance of ending up winning this game.
And he'll be taken down near the 20 at the 21. Call it a gain of a couple, and that's going to leave them with a third and about five.
Bottom line, they want to keep this clock rolling, so they'll take that one right there. They just want to keep falling forward, and they won't put the onus on the big fellas up front in order to bring this one home.
And he'll wind up losing yardage here back at the 21-yard line. It'll be a loss of one, and it'll be fourth down. On this day, the ground has been his, but at least on that individual play, we just saw the defense finally with a win.
Yeah, they finally got one, and that's a win for them, but all game long, he's seen the holes, and they've been huge for him. Kind of like a baseball hitter in the zone, the ball seems bigger, and he's just whacking it. These guys, they got it going today.
And this will not be returnable. It's out of the back of the end zone for a touchback. Here comes Jimmy Garoppolo now to lead his offense back out there. With his guys trailing here in the fourth, he can ill afford a repeat of the interception that ended the last drive.
Yeah, you're two scores down. You take it upon yourself now to play perfect or near-perfect football if you want to get your team back into the game. But it's also tough to do when you're trying to avoid errors, yet still play perfect football.
They're throwing to start the drive, but that one incomplete.
That would have been a great catch, but it's real difficult to hold on to it because it was contested all the way. Would have been a great play if he'd been able to haul that one in.
Line of scrimmage, again the 25, second and 10. Garoppolo to try again on second down. And he'll be hit as he releases it, and that'll fall incomplete.
I think he had to unload that one before he wanted to. He was right up in his grill. I think he was a dentist there without a license, don't you?
Just not enough time for the play to develop. Just lucky it wasn't a fumble, really. So back-to-back incompletions, and that has him staring at a third and 10. A shotgun snap for Garoppolo. And that's incomplete. But the passing game right now for them, not overly impressive. Last week he hit on right at 50%. This week he's under 50%.
And it's not just on him. Protection, few breakdowns along the way has made him get off the spot. Receivers not getting their way open downfield. The coverage has been awfully tight. They've got to all get together and find ways to make this passing game get in gear.
And no, it's incomplete. The Niners go for it, but it doesn't work out. And the Seahawks, they'll get the football back in outstanding field position. So still over 3 minutes remaining in this game, but boy, not getting that one, that hurt.
That's a little bit demoralizing, so they have to be careful about that because still have an opportunity if they can get some things done on defense. But now, since they've taken over on downs, a team with the ball, guess what? Going to four-minute offense, maybe they can put this thing away.
That one goes for 16 yards. It sets them up first and goal. And when do they start thinking about burning these timeouts? They've got all three still defensively.
To me, you have to start right now. Here's the time, and that means you've got to stop them on defense, not give up the yardage, use your timeouts in order to get the ball back and try and score yourself. But now is the time to start using those timeouts.
And keep in mind, it'll also stop the clock at the two-minute warning.
Oh, that's one to warm the hearts of all those old-school football players, isn't it? Tough, hard, gritty run, got behind his pads, bowled over a few people. Look at that one, right up the gut.
So through three quarters, no reason to lighten up now. They give it to him running left. And the reinforcements come in as they're going to stop him behind the line. That'll be a loss of a yard, and it leads to a third down. Now this is a big third down, and you'd have to think we'd see a timeout right away if they can't stop him here. Time for a break. We'll come back and see this one out after this. So it's Seahawk football as we march toward a conclusion. They've got it third and goal here as they try to finish off their victory. Now a run with Martin. Oh, and they had him step short of the first, but a penalty marker down. And that looked like a clear face mask to me.
Face mask. Defense.
They're down here in the fourth, and that personal foul penalty's not going to help.
No, in these types of situations, players will tell you that's extra intensity. From where we sit, it's actually frustration, not a good play.
So So the ball's moved to about the one after the penalty, first and goal. They'll run for it with Martin. And maybe a measure of revenge there. He's had his way in this one, but this time they get him behind the line. Back at the two now, here's second and goal. They come out here in the eye. They get it to him running left. And he's across the chalk, into the end zone, touchdown Seahawks. A great play there with touchdown number 20 on the year. And the Seahawks add on to their lead. And that rushing touchdown is fourth, puts him just one shy of the NFL record in a single game.
And we all know he would love to get to that record and even beyond it. But he doesn't need to in order to impress in this one, does he? What a performance. What an absolute great game that he's had here in this one.
And San Francisco gets set to go here. They're down big here late. I don't know. You just one last drive here for pride?
Some people like to do that. I remember playing for a guy once. We were down huge, and someone said, "Coach, what do you want to call?" He just waved a hand like, "Who cares? Let's get out of here and do something some other time." But some teams like to do something at the end to feel a little bit better
as they continue to
move forward.
Yeah, probably just want to put this one behind them. Now Garoppolo throwing on second. And a big loss here as he's taken down. And now maybe they want some extra time to talk about this third and long play as we'll get a timeout. As he'll get it with just over 90 seconds to go in the ballgame. So the sack of Garoppolo. And now what can they come up with on third and long? To throw is Garoppolo. Try to force it to Allen, and it's intercepted. Picked off at about the 31. And he's going to get this one to the 23-yard line. He was trying to get that one to Allen that time. That's now a second interception in as many weeks from his linebacker position.
And think about all the different techniques he has to employ in a passing situation. Is he spot dropping because it's zone? Is he picking up man-to-man? Is he having to run with a running back or a tight end? In any event, great eyes, head on a swivel, and excellent hands.
Yeah, versatility and showing those hands. 5 yards on the carry, good pickup on first down.
I have to chuckle to myself a little bit, Brandon, because right now, I could be in that huddle with that offensive line. I know exactly what they're saying.
If you call a pass play here, we're going to call timeout. Run the football. We've got control of this thing. Get in behind us and let's go.
Their time to shine. The D can only stop it one more time as they take the knee. And on third down, a nickel formation here defensively. Scoring, there's no doubt about that in this one, Charles. Points, they were not at a premium. They were pretty easy to come by.
They were, but it was fun, wasn't it? Because both teams finding ways to click. And you know people who love this game, they also love baseball games that are 14-11 with three or four home runs mixed in.
So for the Seahawks, the wins keep coming as this one moves them to 12-3 on the year.